HSBC is to cut 50,000 jobs worldwide. Europe's biggest bank is spinning off its Turkish and Brazilian operations, as well as slashing jobs in a move to save $5 billion a year by 2017. The bank is also considering whether to move its headquarters out of the UK. HSBC shares rose slightly earlier, but they're now trading lower in London. Let's bring in our Europe business editor, Nina dos Santos. And Nina, what are some of the details of this plan? It looks like a big change for a bank that had some very global ambitions.
It's a very big number, isn't it? We're talking about 50,000 people here, 50,000 positions that are likely to be cut. Half of those positions, Maggie, are going to go just directly eliminated positions here. And then the other 25,000 of them are likely to go with those units that you mentioned there in underperforming places like Turkey and Brazil for the company, where they're going to be spinning off their divisions over there. So broadly speaking, that's the 50-50 mix of where this 50,000 figure comes in. 50,000 is around about 24% of this company's total workforce. We're talking about an enormous bank here with a really global footprint. It's got about 266,000 staff. And up until very recently, Maggie, this is a bank, remember, that for the best part of 15 years has been branding itself as the world's local bank. Well, for a long time, since at least 2011, when the current CEO, Stuart Gulliver, took over, this is a bank that has seen its footprint deliberately be shrunken by him. He's already eliminated around about 87,000 posts. He's exited a number of countries, shrinking the number of operations that HSBC has around the world in terms of countrywide operations down from 73 to just 15. And what we're seeing here effectively is a pivot towards the more profitable regions of Asia. In particular, HSBC highlighted the China Pearl River Delta, which is a burgeoning part of China. But, you know, for many people here, they might forget that this is a company that was founded in 1865 as HSBC, the Hong Kong and Shanghai Banking Corporation. So to a certain extent, it's only logical that if that part of the world is more profitable, they're going back to their roots.
Nina, they're also considering, as we mentioned, whether to move the headquarters out of Britain. This, I'm sure, is related to the business decision and scaling back, but it's also political as well, isn't it?
A lot of it has to do with regulation here, Maggie. I suppose it's a similar situation where you are in the United States. We keep hearing that banks are finding themselves hindered by more and more reams of red tape, which makes it just more expensive for these companies to do business where they do business. Now, I should also mention that HSBC's had a pretty difficult time recently. Remember that it's been implicated in currency manipulation scandals in places like Switzerland. It got a big wrap around the knuckles from US authorities where you are because of money laundering allegations. And it's had all sorts of issues that, you know, from a reputational point of view, have also been significant too. Let me also bring in a quote here from Stuart Gulliver, the CEO, trying to draw a line under all of these issues here. He's talking about financially why there's a need for change here. We recognize that the world has changed and we need to change with it. The world is increasingly connected, with Asia expected to be a larger part of the business. Just goes on to say that Asia is being expected to show high growth and to become the center of global trade over the next decade. You know, if there's less red tape to contend with in Asia, it's more profitable as well. Well, it's understandable to see why he's putting his eggs in that basket. And the other thing to remember, Maggie, is that, you know, if HSBC manages to gain more assets in a place like Asia before the renminbi, the currency over there, becomes fully convertible, well, obviously those assets will be worth an awful lot more in a few years' time if and when the Chinese government eventually decides to let that Chinese currency float and unpeg it from the dollar.